afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Ann Lacy Stadium, host of the NAIA Opening Round Softball Championship on the campus of Oklahoma City University. The afternoon game is between the Stars of Oklahoma City University and the Vikings of Grandview University. The pitcher for this contest will be in the third base dugout for the Oklahoma City University. Leading off for OCU, starting playing shortstop, number one is Kennedy Jackson. Second, the left fielder, number 11, is Julian Abloh. Batting third, tackle, number 20, is Casey Smith. Batting fourth, second baseman, number 8, is Jordan Perez. Batting fifth, the DP, number 14, is Bailey Whitmore. Batting sixth, the third baseman, number 7, is Lacey Garner. Batting seventh, the center fielder, number 9, is Bailey Lux. Batting eighth, the right fielder, number 4, is Montana Price. And 15, number 12, Abby Metter, batting 9. And in the flex position, batting first base, number 19, is Jason Shore. The head coach of OCU is Phil McFadden, who is assisted by Bobby Bridges, Harold Copas, Guy Cook, and Scott Gallagher. The home team for this contest will be in the first base dugout, their lineup for the Vikings of Grandview. Leading off of batting first base, number 23, is Lexi Merritt. Batting second, the right fielder, number 20, will be Katie Watson. Batting third, the shortstop, number 28, is Lauren Cortinga. Batting fourth, the second baseman, number 14, is Lexi Field. Batting fifth, the catcher, number 31, is Justin Webb. Batting sixth, the DP, number 33, Kate Crow. Batting seventh, the third baseman, number 21, is Maddie Gilgis. Batting eighth, is the left fielder, number 12, is Miranda Nash. Batting 9th and pitching number 11 is Claudia Farrell. And in the duck position, center now, ladies and gentlemen, Riley Wells.
And that was the national anthem sung by Briley Wells. She is the niece of OCU alumna Jen Wells. And we're glad she came from Ponca City. So you heard the starting lineups from Phil Wofford. I will reiterate those for you. The shortstop is number one, Kennedy Jackson for Oklahoma City. Number 11 is the left fielder, Julianne Ablo. The catcher is J.C. Smith. Batting cleanup is the second baseman, Brittany Perez. The DP, Bailey Whitmore. The third baseman, Lacey Joyner. The center fielder, Bailey Lux. The right fielder, Montana Price. Pitching will be Abby Metter. And the first baseman, Jaden Shores. For Grandview, around the diamond will go like this. Lexi Merritt, the first baseman. And then the second baseman is Lexi Beal. Shortstop will be Lauren Portinga. And the third baseman, Maddie Thilgis. And then left fielder is Miranda Nash. The center fielder is Carrie Adams. And the right fielder, Kaylee Watson. Pitching will be Claudia Farrell. And Claudia Farrell, 29-4. 276 strikeouts and 212 and two-thirds innings. She will be pitching for the third time in this opening round. It's the NAIA Softball Championship opening round Oklahoma City bracket. And this is the championship game. At stake is a NAIA Softball World Series appearance. And if Oklahoma City were to win one today, they would make their 31st World Series appearance. And Grandview is looking for their second. They would need to win two. Here's the first pitch from Claudia Farrell, and it will come through at 12:08. And it's a ball to Kennedy Jackson. Kennedy Jackson hitting 452 with no home runs and 21 RBIs. Lined out to the shortstop, Lauren Portinga, for out number one. Julianne Ablo hitting 360 with no home runs and 31 RBIs. With one away here in the top of the first, we're just underway here. First pitch is a strike to Ablo. Doug Swanger is the home plate umpire. Theron Scott and David Goodson are the other umpires. Around the diamond. This one's hit foul. It's 73 degrees with a north wind at 7 miles an hour, but right now the flags in above center field are still, which is not a common occurrence here in Oklahoma. The wind blows. It's an 0-2 count now to Ablo. And the pitch, it's going to be fouled away. We're glad you joined us here. I'm Rich Tortorelli, alongside Robbie Holzberger and Phil Wofford. We're live from Ann Lacy Stadium. And the pitch, it's going to be fouled away. And Oklahoma City is also the two-time defending national champions, 10-time national champion overall. The 0-2 pitch, fouled away. And the 0-2 pitch again, this is going to be fouled away again. And Ablo battling, she's fouled off five straight pitches. And Claudia Farrell gets a word from her third baseman, Maddie Thilgis from Grandview. The 0-2 pitch, it's going to be fouled away again. And Lexi Merritt's turn to say something to Claudia Farrell. Claudia Farrell, the ace for Grandview. She's the four-time conference pitcher of the year. In the Heart of America Athletic Conference, that one's fouled away again by Ablo. Ablo is a junior from Santa Paula, California. This one's going to be hit over to the third baseman. So we've got a base hit for Julian Ablo. And third baseman for Grandview. Manny Thill just getting the glove on it, but not able to make the throw. It's J.C. Smith, the catcher. J.C. Smith hitting .417, 11 home runs, and 65 RBIs. And bunt hit here for J.C. Smith, and she's safe, so she will be aboard with a base hit. She singled to the pitcher. And that makes... That's two runners on first and second for the Stars, with one away here. Next up, we have Brittany Perez hitting .370, 11 home runs and 49 RBIs. Brittany Perez has a home run in this tournament, so does J.C. Smith. Both those came the first day against Tabor. And we have a visit here in the circle with the infield.
Well, others in there.
And again, one away here. In the championship game of the NAIA Softball Championship opening round Oklahoma City bracket, there are 10 opening rounds being played around the country. And first pitch to Perez is a strike. There have been some World Series berths already won. And as some of the opening rounds have concluded, we'll get to those at some point during this broadcast. And the pitch, it's going to be swung through by Brittany Perez. Here's the 0-2 pitch, swung at, popped up. Center fielder is going to be underneath it, and she will put the glove on it. And that was Kerry Adams for Grandview, making the put out. Bailey Whitmore, the DP for Oklahoma City, hitting .406, one home run, and 53 RBIs. Oklahoma City enters today at 50-7.
Get them back over there on this play ball.
And Oklahoma City has 22 50-win seasons in the program's history, 21 under Phil McSpadden. And that one's lined at the shortstop. Nice play by Lauren Portinga. Great glove work. But that'll retire the side here. Two hits and two left. Moving on to the bottom of the first. Grandview pulls out the bats.
Closing off for Grandview, first base of number 23, Lexi Merritt.
Lexi Merritt, the first baseman for Grandview, leading off for the Vikings. She's hitting 398 with 6 home runs and 38 RBIs. And pitching is Abby Metter. She will wind and deliver upstairs. Metter, 0.47 earned run average, 14-1 record, 158 strikeouts, 103 and 2/3 innings. The 1-0 pitch. One now to Merritt. Metter entered the tournament leading the NAIA in several categories, including ERA and fewest runs allowed, fewest earned runs allowed, fewest hits allowed. And outside now, ball two to Merritt. Upstairs for a ball. And Metter will wind and deliver. This is going to be popped up and foul and out of play. Beyond our reach. Bottom of the first, no score between Oklahoma City and Grandview. The 1-1 pitch. In there for the strike. One ball, two strikes. The 1-2 pitch. Now it's 2-2. Two balls, two strikes. Here's the pitch. Called third strike. Two strikeouts for Abby Metter. Lauren Partinka, the shortstop for Grandview, hitting 341, 13 home runs, and 57 RBIs. Marion is a qualifier for the World Series. Marion out of Indiana won the Bowling Green bracket, and Faulkner won the other Bowling Green bracket. First pitch to Portinga swung through for a strike. The 0-1 pitch, it's going to be swung at for Portinga. The 0-2 pitch, it's going to be swung at and fouled away. In the Fayette bracket, Hope International, Central Methodist, and Columbia remain trying to decide that one. Fouled away, and this one's going to be unplayable for Jaden Shores, and she comes away with it for out number three. 1-2-3 inning, going to the second inning. You're watching the NAIA Softball Championship opening round, Oklahoma City bracket. Brings up the third baseman for Oklahoma City, Lacy Joyner, to lead off the second inning. Joyner hitting 406, one home run, and 53 RBIs. Ball one to her, Lacy Joyner. Scored one of the runs yesterday against Grandview. Scored on Bailey Lux's single. 2-0 now to Joyner. The Dodge City bracket, Science and Arts of Oklahoma and Midland remain. They are playing theirs. They should be underway in Dodge City. 2-1 the count now. Here's the pitch. It's going to be swung at and fouled away. In Lawrenceville, Georgia, Georgia Gwinnett has advanced to the World Series. In Columbia, Kentucky, it was Freed Hardeman advancing to the World Series. Southern Oregon and St. Francis remain in that bracket. The 2-2 pitch, in there for the strike. So Bailey Lux, the batter. Bailey Lux hitting 379, three home runs, 38 RBIs. Bailey Lux yesterday had two RBIs, went 2-for-3. Had an infield single to score one run, and had a base hit to right to score a couple more. Hit foul and out of play over in the bullpen. In the Gulf Shores bracket, remaining teams there are Bernal and Mobile. Hit deep, going deep to left field, off the wall. Bailey Lux looking for extra bases. She'll get the double. And the Stars are in business with one out here in the second. Scores from the Oklahoma City bracket. Grandview defeated Tabor 4-0 on Monday. And then Eastern Oregon defeated by Oklahoma City 4-0 on Monday. Here's the pitch to Montana Price. It'll be in there for the strike. Montana Price, the right fielder for Oklahoma City, hitting 360 with 11 home runs. Runner on second with one out here in the second inning. Swung through by Montana Price. And the catcher, Kristen Webb, tries to catch Lux napping. But Lux will be safe at second. The 0-2 pitch, swung at and grounded foul. O2 pitch, it's going to be popped up. It will be in the infield. And the second baseman for Grandview, Lexi Beal, comes away with it. Out number two. And Abby Metter, 279 hitter with one home run and 26 RBIs. She will look to help her cause with two outs and a runner on second. First pitch to Metter is low for a ball. And Claudia Farrell also hits for herself. She's batting in the ninth spot of the Grandview order. The pitch from Farrell is a ball, 2-0 the count now. On Tuesday, scores from this tournament, Oklahoma City defeated Grandview 3-0, and then Tabor defeated Eastern Oregon 1-0 to knock out Eastern Oregon. Upstairs for a off for Grandview is Lexi Beal. Here's the pitch. Upstairs for a ball.
Just a bit.
In the Hattiesburg bracket, Indiana Wesleyan and Truett McConnell remain trying to decide that World Series berth. The 1-0 pitch. In there for the strike. This is opening round central here at Oklahoma City University, because Oklahoma City University hosting both the NAIA Softball Championship opening round and the NAIA Baseball Championship opening round. 1-1 now to Beal. Beal hitting .326, 13 home runs and 48 RBIs. She will look at strike two. Congratulations go out to Lane Milligan of Oklahoma City. He hit his 15th triple of the season last night, and that will break the NAIA single season record. 1-2 pitch, swung through. Already three strikeouts for Abby Metter. And so the catcher, Kristen Webb, .337 average, one home run and 18 RBIs. Congratulations go out to her. She had her first career home run last night. It was a grand slam. The first pitch to her hit foul. That was part of that big victory by Grandview last night. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Webb will square to bunt and foul away. Oh, 2 now to Webb. All-American Abby Metter, four-time All-Sooner Athletic Conference. She has thrown one-hit shutouts these last two games here in the opening round. Two balls, two strikes to Webb. And here's the pitch. Popped up into right field, base hit. And Kate Crow, the designated player for Grandview, hitting .301, one home run, and 27 RBIs. That's from left side. So runner aboard for the Vikings. And that will miss low. Ball one to Kate Crow. The 1-0 pitch. In there for the strike. Thank you. Strike two to Webb. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Swung at and popped foul. Over by the hitting facility here at Ann Lacy Stadium. The 1-2 pitch, ball two now. Ann Lacy Stadium has hosted an opening round every year of the format since it was introduced in 2013. Runner on second, 2-2 pitch coming up. Now full count to Crow. Also, over the years, Oklahoma City University has hosted the Sooner Athletic Conference tournament. Here's the payoff pitch. Swung through. Four strikeouts for Abby Meador. Maddie Thilgis, the third baseman, 314 average, two home runs and 27 RBIs. And snap throw to first. Webb is safe at first. And hit to the third baseman, Lacey Joyner. She will go up with it and get out number three. One hit and one left. Grandview retired in the second, going on to the third inning. You're watching the NAIA Softball Championship opening round, Oklahoma City Bracket. The shortstop, Kennedy Jackson, now batting for the Stars. 0-1 on the day. You see the second baseman shadowing the pitcher. Hit up the middle, base hit for Kennedy Jackson. She will foil the shift.
Brings up the left fielder, number 11, Julianne Aplo.
Now Julianne Aplo takes the first pitch for a strike, and now the first baseman is moving up to see if she can catch Aplo bunting as well. And now a bunt attempt fouled away. Popped up in the infield, Patinga, the shortstop, underneath it. Out number one with runner on first. Two strikes to J.C. Smith with one out, and starts with four hits today. The 0-2 pitch, it's going to be swung through by J.C. Smith. And Brittany Perez now the batter. Perez with a fly out to center field in her first at-bat. Claudia Farrell with 40 pitches thrown, 34 for strikes so far. First pitch to Brittany Perez is going to be hit into right field. And the second baseman for Grandview, Lexi Beal, puts the glove on it for the third out. The bottom of the third coming up.
Grandview, left fielder, number 12, Miranda Nash.
Brenda Nash, the left fielder for Grandview now. Miranda Nash hitting 143, two RBIs, one home run. She takes the first pitch for a strike. In there for the strike, 0-2. How about this for a statistical oddity? Every game in this tournament has been decided by a shutout. The winning team has pulled off a shutout in every game. Something to think about. The 0-2 pitch. And Nash does not go fishing. Lays off for ball one. On deck is Claudia Farrell. And the 1-2 pitch. And it looks like that one will hit her. Yeah. Leadoff runner aboard for Grandview for the first time today. And Claudia Farrell hitting 300, four home runs and 19 RBIs. Jaden Shores with a word for the pitcher, Abby Metter. She's another pitcher for the Stars, playing first base today. And Claudia Farrell offers that one. This is going to be a snap throw to first, and Nash will be out. Picked off by J.C. Smith and Brittany Perez. J.C. Smith is a fan of that snap throw to first. So 0-1 pitch now is a ball to Nash, and now the bases are clear with one out. One ball, one strike. To Farrell, it's two balls now. J.C. Smith bring the ball out to Abby Metter. Quick word now. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Upstairs, ball three. Three balls, one strike. Swung through by Farrell, full count now to her. Farrell, the senior pitcher from Des Moines, Iowa. As you can imagine, majority of Grandview's team is from Iowa. Ball four to Farrell. Runner aboard now for Lexi Merritt at the top of the order, 398 average entering today. And Lou Yasinich now is going to make a substitution at first, running for Claudia Farrell. And that'll be the center fielder, Carrie Adams, moving up from the flex position. So Merritt in there for the strike. The 0-1 pitch in there for the strike, 0-2. And this one's going to be grounded to Kennedy Jackson at short, and she will throw to second and get the lead runner. So Merritt trades places with Kerry Adams.
Oh, the whole scoreboard went off.
So Kaylee Watson, the right fielder. Watson 0 for 1 today. She was a strikeout victim in the first. We still have no score between Oklahoma City and Grandview. Strike one to Watson. Oklahoma City with four hits and Grandview with one hit. Have had runners reach this inning and by hit by pitch and a walk. Popped up foul and out of play, 0-2 now. So again, this is a superb pitching matchup. Two masters of their craft, Abby Metter and Claudia Farrell, going for Oklahoma City and Grandview. The 0-2 pitch. And that'll do Watson in, called third strike. We'll move on to the fourth inning with no score between these two teams. DP, Bailey Whitmore, 0 for 1 today. We're in the top of the fourth. Neither team has scored so far. First pitch to Whitmore is a strike. And you'd expect runs to be at a premium against these two premier pitchers. It's the postseason for softball. The best pitchers are at play right now. One ball, one strike. Phil McSpadden is fond of saying that the game revolves around the circle. Popped up foul and out of play. If you're building a softball team, you want to start with a premier pitcher. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Grounded to the second baseman, and she will try to make the play at first, and there she is making it. Wonderful play by Lexi Beal. Ranging over to the right and making the throw to beat Bailey Whitmore. Ranging to her left, I should say. And Lacey Joyner now batting for the Stars. Takes the first pitch for a strike. 0 for 1 on the day. Swung at and fouled away by Joyner. Lacy Joyner is one of many sister combinations that have played for the Stars. She had an older sister named Tori who played for OCU. Became an All-American. 0-2 pitch. Upstairs. 1-2 now. And Lacy Joyner has been on the last two national championship teams. She's one of two seniors for this OCU squad. This is going to be hit to left field, but the left fielder for Grandview, Miranda Nash, is underneath it. Out number two.
Number nine.
Bailey Lux.
Center fielder.
Number nine for OCU, the center fielder. Doubled in her last at bat.
Come on, Bailey.
Also a sister combination for OCU, Shea Ingram. And Amanda Ingram. Amanda Ingram graduated last year. Shea Ingram is on this year's team. 0-1 the count now to Lux. The 0-1 pitch in there for the strike. Popped up by Lux, and Claudia Farrell collects it. That'll be out number three. Stars down in order, moving on to the bottom of the fourth. You're watching the NAIA Softball Championship opening round, Oklahoma City Bracket. Leadoff batter for Grandview will be Lauren Portinga, the shortstop. And Portinga is 0-for-1 on the day. Abby Metter will again take the circle for the Stars. Enters play today with the most strikeouts in the tournament, 19 strikeouts. Inside for ball one to Portinga. Five strikeouts already now for Abby Metter. Two balls now to Portinga. Metter enters today with 12 complete games to her credit on the season. Here's the 2-0 pitch. In there for the strike. Two balls, one strike here in the bottom of the fourth. This is going to be hit up the middle, base hit. Portinho aboard for Grandview. And Lexi Beal, the second baseman for Grandview. And there will be a move at first. And Cammie Wheelock will be the courtesy runner.
Number four is Cammie Wheelock.
Beal, it was a strikeout victim in the second. Runner on first, and now we have Beal laying down the bunt. Abby Metter will field it and throw to first. Brittany Perez covers it, and there's a sacrifice bunt. Vikings move the runner to scoring position. For Kristen Webb. Webb has one of Grandview's two hits today. Ball one to Webb. Popped up, sky high pop up, and underneath it will be the left fielder for Oklahoma City, Julian Abloh. Abloh earlier against Eastern Oregon turned a double play, caught a fly ball, and then threw the runner out at first. There's been some nice double plays in this tournament, turned by Oklahoma City and Grandview and the other teams in this tournament. Kate Crow, the DP. 1-0 the count now to her. We're in the bottom of the fourth, and again, Grandview is the home team for this game. Foul that one away.
Are you going to bring? No, that's not what I was asking you about. I'm going to Boston.
One ball, one strike now. Two away. And the pitch in there for the strike. The 1-2 pitch swung at and fouled away. One ball, two strikes, two outs here. Abby Metter delivers as we popped up, but out of play for J.C. Smith. We're glad to see a good turnout of Oklahoma City University staff on hand here in the stands. Take some time out of their work day. One ball and two strikes. To cheer on the Stars. Two balls, two strikes now to Crow. And the pitch swung through. Six strikeouts for Abby Metter. We're still scoreless. Heading to the fifth inning. You're watching the NAIA Softball Championship opening round, Oklahoma City bracket.
So we're going to four innings, go through a lot of Grizzuro.
Should be Portinga.
Hitting off the top half of the fifth inning for OCU, Rod Fielder, number four, Montana Price.
Montana Price leads off for Oklahoma City against Claudia Farrell. Ball one to Price. Claudia Farrell is 29-4 on the year. She entered yesterday with 11 wins in her last 12 starts. She hits that one foul. Farrell picked up the loss yesterday against Oklahoma City, but also had a loss against in her conference tournament. One of few against Claudia Farrell. Montana Price hits that one foul. One ball, two strikes to Price. And check swing fouled away. One ball, two strikes now. And again, hit foul by Price. Farrell with a 104 and 19 record in her Grandview career, 1,055 strikeouts in 803 and one-third innings. All those numbers entering today. Two balls and two strikes. That is exclusive company within the NAI to have 1,000 strikeouts in your career. Popped up foul back to the screen. The 2-2 pitch swung at and fouled away back to the screen. In this at bat, Montana Price has fouled it away 6 times. 8 pitches total in this at bat. And swung through by Price. Three strikeouts for Claudia Farrell.
Come on, Abby.
She had 5 against OCU yesterday. And Abby Metter takes the first pitch for a strike.
Right down the right field line, down at the very corner. Off the second base.
One ball, one strike, and one away for Abby Meador. Abby Meador lined out to first base earlier. And now a base hit to left field. Abby Meador will be aboard. And Kennedy Jackson at the plate for Oklahoma City with one out. This one's going to be bunted past the third baseman. Drag bunt by KK Jackson. That was beautiful. A beautiful bunt by KK Jackson. So runners on first and second. Julian Ablo. And now Bobby Bridges, the assistant coach for Oklahoma City, talking to Phil McSpadden, the head coach. And Phil McSpadden, with well over 1,650 wins, 1,650 wins, he has the most wins against four-year competition in college softball history. Back in 2015, he surpassed the NCAA career leader in wins. To bat with two outs, two runners on. And the pitch swung at and fouled away. Still no score between these two teams, but a golden opportunity for the Stars with runners on first and second. And two outs here in the fifth inning. Here's the pitch. It's going to be fouled away. O-2 pitch. Outside for a ball. 1-2 now. Still locked in a scoreless tie. One ball, two strikes. Timeout called. And for Grandview, it'll be Lexi Merritt with a word for Claudia Farrell, her pitcher. One ball, two strikes. For J.C. Smith. Three-hole hitter for Oklahoma City. And now she'll step out of the batter's box, and now it'll be Kristen Webb's turn to have her 2 cents. J.C. Smith, one of the top run producers in the NAIA. She is 11th in the NAIA in run RBIs per game. and 12th in with her 65 RBIs. One ball, two strikes. Two outs. Here's the pitch. And now it'll be J.C. Smith swinging through, and catcher will Kristen Webb will miss the catch, but she'll throw over to first and get the out. So 2-4 on the put out. Two runs, two hits, and two left. We're still scoreless entering the bottom of the fifth.
Now see, that been Maddie Ellis. That's what she did at the best. All the pressure was on her. She knew all the metal. She knew everything she could for you. Knock it out of the park. Hit a triple or a double. Her and Callie both that way. Well, there at the bottom there.
Maddie Thill just leads off for Grandview here in the bottom of the fifth. Thill just 0 for 1 on the day. Abby Metter will begin her fifth inning of work for Oklahoma City. One 0 now to Thilgis. Some of those pitchers that are listed with 1,000 career strikeouts on the NAI record book, the 1-0 pitch, and that'll be ball two. With 1,257 strikeouts, it was Rachel Murray for Union University out of Tennessee from 1999 to 2000. She would have been the NAI record holder for a long time then, because she's the earliest mentioned on this group. The 2-0 pitch swung at and fouled away. With 1,320 strikeouts from Madonna was Jessica Irwin. She played from 08 to 11. And Nicole Nonnemacher from St. Xavier, 2013 to 16. 2-1 pitch now to Philgis. In there for the strike. Nonnemacher was able to deal Oklahoma City a 1-0 loss, or I think it may have been 2-0, in the 2016 World Series. But Oklahoma City came back to win the national championship, defeating St. Xavier twice in the championship game. Popped up foul on the last day. And I mentioned Lily Lavelle, the NAI career record strikeout record holder. Lily Lavelle from Oklahoma City played played in this stadium from 09 to 12. So those are the four pitchers listed with 1,000 career strikeouts in the NAI history. In the dirt to Thilgis. So full count to Thilgis. And the pitch, it's going to be popped up. And Kennedy Jackson and the left fielder Julian Abloh are after it. It'll be Julian Abloh to make the play. One away now in the bottom of the fifth. Abby Meador with 783 career strikeouts entering today. That would be 789 with the six that she's gotten today. Swung through. She has 33 career shutouts, 52 career complete games, 86-8 in her OCU career, Abby Meador. 0.98 ERA. 0-1 pitch in there for the strike.
Last time, Miranda. Go call it.
And in that other dugout, Claudia Farrell with 37 career strikeouts, or excuse me, 37 career shutouts and 94 complete games in her Grandview career. Swing and miss by Nash. And here she is again, Claudia Farrell. She also has a career 288 career batting average. .124 career ERA. So strike one to Farrell. Farrell walked in the third inning. We still have no score between these two teams, bottom of the fifth, and you can imagine the reason why is Abby Meador in the circle for Oklahoma City, and in the batter's box, Claudia Farrell for Grandview. Two of the premier pitchers in the NAI. O2 pitch swung at, popped up. Center fielder Bailey Lux is after it, but it'll be Julian Abloh calling her off. And Grandview will be retired in order in the fifth inning, going to the sixth inning. And no score between Oklahoma City and Grandview. Anthony Perez leads off for Oklahoma City, takes the first pitch for a ball. We're in the top of the sixth. And an NAIA Softball World Series berth is at stake. Oklahoma City needs one win to secure that. Grandview needs two wins. Ball two to Perez. And if you're a fan of pitching duels, you've come to the right place. The 2-0 pitch upstairs, ball three. OCU has had six hits today, and Grandview with two hits so far. Here's the 3-0 pitch. So Brittany Perez aboard with a walk, and that'll be the first walk issued by Claudia Farrell. Bailey Whitmore with 4.01 average gets the signals from Phil McSpadden. She is 0. Bailey Whitmore 0 for 2 today. Runner on first with nobody out. Stars with the leadoff. Batter aboard. Strike one to Whitmore. Bailey Whitmore is played locally at Westmore in her prep days. The 0-1 pitch, she will offer, showing bunt, but it looks like it'll be a ball one to her. So ball one, one ball, one strike, and there's an appeal to the field umpire, and he agrees it's ball one. And the pitch is going to be swung at and lined into left field. Perez will round second, coming to third, digging for home. And the Stars have scored. And that'll go down as a double for Bailey Whitmore. RBI base hit. Oklahoma City leads 1-0. Give Bailey Whitmore her 17th double of the year. She'll be run for by Shea Ingram. Next, we have Lacey Joyner. Nobody out here. Runner in scoring position for Oklahoma City.
Shea Ingram.
All right. 1-0 OCU leads. And showing bunt, Lacey Joyner will pop this one foul over the head of Phil McSpadden over at third base. Third in the coaching box. Strike one to Joyner. She shows bunt again, but she will pull back. She lines it to the first baseman, and first baseman will throw to first, and she will advance the runner. Ingram to third with one out. Nope, excuse me. Ingram stays at second. Ingram stays at second on the play. So one away, and runner still in scoring position. Bailey Lux is the batter. Bailey Lux has come up with timely hits during this tournament. And in the postseason, also in the conference tournament for Oklahoma City. She came through yesterday with two base hits and two RBIs. Bailey Lux is the freshman from Reno, Nevada. And this one's going to be hit. Going back. Over at the warning track, it'll be off the wall. Bailey Lux will round second, heading to third, and Shane Ingram will score. Triple for Bailey Lux, and now Bailey Lux will come home on the throwing error.
Now batting for OCU, fielder, Montana Price.
Three runs in for Oklahoma City in this inning. Bailey Lux with the triple off the wall. And she gets home on the throwing error. Montana Price next for Oklahoma City. 3-0, Stars in the lead. Price with the ball. Ball one. And this one's going to be grounded to first baseman. That'll be out number two. Lexi Merritt steps on first and retires Montana Price. Abby Metter will be up with two outs. First pitch to Abby Metter will be a ball. Metter has been unselfish this year, playing both pitcher. When she's not pitching, she's been playing right field. And ball two, the second pitch is a strike to Abby Metter. 1-1 pitch is going to be fouled away over by the Grandview dugout. Better now. 1-2 pitch is going to be fouled away. The 1-2 pitch, it's going to be fouled away again. 90 pitches now thrown by Claudia Farrell. Two balls, two strikes to Abby Metter. The right-handed hitter from Midwest City, Oklahoma. 2-2 pitch is going to be swung at and fouled away. And in the on-deck circle is Kennedy Jackson. She has a word for Abby Metter, word of encouragement. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. And the pitch is going to be fouled away. Is it playable? No, it'll be off the backstop. Two balls, two strikes. And the pitch swung at, and this one's going to be popped up and lined to the third baseman for Maddie Filgis. But damage done. Stars with three runs, two hits, one error. And in the inning, it was Bailey Whitmore with the RBI double. And then Bailey Lux with a triple off the wall. And the Stars lead 3-0 going into the bottom of the sixth.
bottom half of the sixth inning for Grandview, third baseman, number 23, Lexi Merritt.
Bottom of the sixth now, and Oklahoma City leads 3-0 against Grandview. Grandview will send up Lexi Merritt, and on deck is Kaylee Watson to face Abby Metter. And 1-0, 1-0 pitch now from Abby Metter. Lexi Merritt with a ball. One ball, no strikes. Here's the pitch. In there for the strike, catches the outside corner. The 1-1 pitch. Swung at it. This is grounded up the middle. Base hit, it looks like. Bailey Lux will collect it. Merritt is aboard with Grandview's third hit of the day. And Kaylee Watson, the right fielder for the Vikings, 0-for-2 today, struck out twice. Lauren Portinga on deck. And Merritt is the leadoff batter aboard for Grandview. Here's the pitch, it's upstairs. The 1-0 pitch, in there for the strike. One ball, one strike, and the pitch. Swung at, popped up, and in foul territory, Lacey Joyner, the third baseman, comes up with it. Out number one.
Brings up the shortstop, number 28, Lauren Portinga.
Lauren Portinga, the shortstop for Grandview, 1-for-2 today. And she takes the first pitch for a strike. Oklahoma City owns 10 national championships. Oklahoma City won 4 in a row in the 90s, 94, 95, 96, and 97. 0-1 pitch. Popped up into right field. Going back at the warning track. It'll be off the glove for Montana Price. But a base hit for Portinga with one away and runners at first and second for Lexi Beal, the cleanup hitter for Grandview. 0-for-2 Beal today. Grandview with a runner in scoring position. And a nice opportunity with two runners aboard. Oklahoma City with a 3-0 lead. Bottom of the sixth here. In there for the strike. Grandview is the home team on the scoreboard. And then Oklahoma City won 3 in a row in 2001 and 02. 3 national championships. Coming back for the 07 national championship and has won the last 2 in 16 and 17. One ball, one strike, and now we have a throw over to second, and Merritt will be safe. Portinga at first, aboard with the single, and Merritt led off with the single. We have one away here in the bottom of the sixth. And Lexi Beal with the 1-1 count. Looks like the wind's blowing in based on the flags. Here's the pitch. It's going to be popped up. Who gets it? Lacey Joyner, the third baseman for Oklahoma City for the second out. And Lacey Joyner gets both outs here so far. In this inning, and then Kristen Webb, the catcher for Grandview, with two away here in the bottom of the sixth. Meador will wind and deliver. Here's the pitch. In there for the strike. Grandview has made the national tournament play 4 years in a row, all under Lou Yasinich. A one pitch. One ball, one strike. 92 pitches thrown by Abby Meador today. She topped 100 pitches earlier against Eastern Oregon. Here's the 1-1 pitch. In there for the strike. 1-2 now to Webb. One ball, two strikes. Here's the pitch upstairs. Ball two now. Two balls, two strikes now. And the pitch. Hit right at Brittany Perez. Perez comes away with it. Out number three in the bottom of the sixth, going to the seventh inning. Oklahoma City leads 3-0. Top of the seventh, Oklahoma City will send the top of the order to the plate. Kennedy Jackson, Julian Ablo, and J.C. Smith do up. Facing Claudia Farrell, this is going to be popped up into right field. Base hit for Kennedy Jackson. Right on the edge of the outfield grass. That bell fell. And nine hits now for Oklahoma City, and Julian Ablo will be the batter. And Ablo will show bunt, and Kennedy Jackson will be at second with her 36th steal of the year. Earlier in this tournament, she was caught stealing for the first time this season. Runner at second with nobody out, and we have a bunt laid down by Ablo. Farrell will throw to first. Runner now on third. It was 1-4 bunt sacrifice to move Jackson to third with one out now for J.C. Smith. winner of this, if Oklahoma City were to hold on and win this game, they would secure their 31st NAIA Softball World Series appearance. This is going to be popped up in the right field. It is shallow and too shallow to, whoa. And looks like Kennedy Jackson tries to go up the line to force the throw. It's on target. So Kaylee Watson with the catch for out number two. And now Louis Asinish to talk to the home plate umpire. Let's see what he has up his sleeve. And Brittany Perez is coming to the plate. Perez walked in the sixth inning. She scored then on Bailey Whitmore's double. And then Whitmore was run for by Shea Ingram in the sixth. Bailey Lux with the triple off the wall, and that made the score 3-0 when she scored on the throwing error on the play. So Stars scored all three in the sixth inning.
What was the first one?
22 for 11. I heard 22 for 11, but then there's another sub.
Yeah, the third one, 22. 24 for 31.
Mm. That's the first one.
Okay, that she's the catcher.
And number 11.
3 for 12.
Molly Ferrell will be.
3 for 12.
Left field.
Okay. Alrighty then.
And 22 for 11.
Got it. Curtain call for some of Grandview's seniors. And we'll have some substitutions. It'll be Kelsey Winnett will take over at catcher for Kristen Webb. Miranda Nash is substituted for in left field by Jillian Bilyeu. And now pitching will be Libby Yinger for, she comes in for Claudia Farrell. Farrell finishes the day 98 pitches and 76 for strikes. 6 2/3 innings for Farrell. 9 hits allowed, 3 runs, 2 earned, 1 walk, and 4 strikeouts. But her responsibility is the runner at third. And Brittany Perez will be at the plate with 2 outs here in the seventh inning. Top of the seventh. First pitch to Perez is a ball. So the Grandview crowd giving a hand to some of the seniors for this Viking team. So hit by pitch for Perez puts runners at the corners for the DP, Bailey Whitmore. And Whitmore shows bunt, and she will pull back and take a strike, and then we have a defensive indifference to move Perez to second. No throw from the catcher. 0-1 pitch is going to be grounded to the shortstop. Portinga throws to the first, and that will retire the side for Oklahoma City in the seventh inning. We'll move on to the bottom of the seventh. Oklahoma City up 3-0. And Grandview is going to send up Kate Crow, Maddie Filges, and Jillian Bilyeu, unless he were to re-enter Miranda Nash. Crow now to lead off here in the bottom of the seventh for Grandview.
Number 33, the DT, J. Crow.
So the two-time defending national champion Oklahoma City, three outs away from securing an NAIA Softball World Series berth. First pitch to Crow is a ball. Grandview looking to extend the inning, extend the game. Here in the bottom of the seventh, Grandview is the home team for this game. And the pitch, it's going to be outside, ball two. And J.C. Smith with a word for Abby Metter. Abby Metter with her... Abby Metter for out for her seventh inning of work. She has thrown 97 pitches, 64 for strikes. She has struck out seven so far today. In there for the strike, 2-1 the count now. The 2-1 pitch. Ball three now. Three balls and one strike now to Crow. This is going to be grounded past the diving Brittany Perez at second. Base hit for Crow. Leadoff runner aboard for Grandview. Maddie Thilgis is going to be the third baseman. Coming to the plate. And we'll have a substitution at first. Allie Woodward will be running for Crow.
Brittany Browning is number 10, Allie Woodward.
And on deck, is Jillian Bilyeu. Pitches thrown by Abby Metter today. That's 101. Ball one to Thilgis. The 1-0 pitch is upstairs for ball two. And J.C. Smith up to talk to Abby Metter for a moment. We're in the bottom of the seventh. Runner on first for Grandview. Oklahoma City with three runs on nine hits today. Grandview with five hits today. The 2-0 pitch. 3-0 the count now. And Phil just shows bunt, takes strike one. 3-1 the count now to Phil just. Three balls, one strike. Here's the pitch. And that will be ball four to Thilgis. Runners on first and second, nobody out for Grandview. Jillian Bilyeu is going to be the batter with nobody out. Runners on first and second. Harold Kopis, longtime pitching coach for Oklahoma City, out to talk to Abby Metter. Longtime pitching guru here in the state of Oklahoma. And now Phil McSpadden joins the discussion with the umpire. Jaden Shores will leave the game, and it'll be Bailey Whitmore taking over at first. I imagine that means that Jaden Shores will be getting ready to pitch. Should she be needed?
Does that mean she's getting her out, right? Jaden Shores?
Runners on first and second for Grandview. Bellew at the plate. Bellew is hitting 105 on the season. And the pitch. Strike one. No balls, one strike. Here's the pitch. In there for the strike. Strike two to Bellew. O-2 pitch. Swung at. Popped up right at Abby Metter. Might have hit her in the face. And Bellew is going to be looked at by the trainer for Grandview.
So that is out number one, right?
What?
One out, right?
Should be an out.
Or is it she just fouled it off?
She fouled it off and hit her in the head.
But if it hits her body, it doesn't make any difference. Huh? She caught it in the air.
Abby caught it in the air. So now there's they're looking at Bellew here. And she actually may have fouled it off of herself. Maybe she might still be up. We'll see here in a moment. She might still be batting here and not retired. She would have an 0-2 count in that instance. And Lou Yasinich is going to see if she can get a drink of water and collect herself.
And you hit yourself. When you throw a strike and you hit yourself, it was an out. It is in baseball. It used to be. She swung the bat. She hit it off the bat and hit her in the face.
So Oklahoma City up 3-0 here, bottom of the seventh, nobody out. We have a runner on first now.
That's Lindsay Lang on first. So it looks like it's a pinch runner.
So running on first is Lindsay Lang. And Bellew will be back up. So she fouled it off her face. We'll do it again with an 0-2 count. And the pitch. Popped up and fouled and out of play. So nobody out, runners on first and second for Grandview. It looks like Bellew fouled it off of her face. And it looked like Abby Metter caught it, but because she fouled it away, she is still up.
Oh, I got it, Bobby. She hit something after it touched her back.
And then popped up and hits the backstop. So now 0-2.
Can't
again to Bellew. Again in the bullpen, we have Jaden Shores, the sophomore from Blanchard. She swings and misses. Bellew will strike out. And Libby Yinger, the pitcher for Grandview. That's 8 strikeouts for Abby Metter. And out number 1 of the bottom of the 7th. First pitch to Yinger is a strike. Runners on first and second for Grandview with one out. Swung through by Yinger. Libby Yinger with one hit this year in 11 at-bats. 0-2 pitch swung through, and that'll be 9 strikeouts for Abby Metter.
Now batting for Grandview, the leadoff hitter and first baseman, number 23, Lexi Merritt.
And Lexi Merritt with 2 away here in the bottom of the 7th for Grandview.
My pulse, I'm probably up about 100 right now. Usually it's about 72, 73.
Strike 1 to Merritt. Ball 1 now to Merritt. 2 down for Grandview here in the bottom of the 7th. Foul back to the backstop. Grandview down to their last strike. Abby Metter trying to close it out for Oklahoma City. So there it is, folks. Merritt flies out to left field for the final out for Grandview. So congratulations to Oklahoma City, returning to the NAIA Softball World Series for the 31st time, looking to defend their national championship. Oklahoma City has won the last 2 national championships. Oklahoma City wins 3-0. We thank you for joining us on the broadcast. And here with the trophy presentation will be Jim Abbott. And here's the PA announcer for Oklahoma City, Phil Wofford.
Mr. Jim Abbott, who is the vice president of the University of Oklahoma City University. And here they come. And here's the trophy. Congratulations, girls. You did a great job with the girls in action. The girls are at the record. By surgery. And also, may I say again, congratulations to Grandview for a tremendous season. Great coaching. Good job.